Welcome to day four of Teresa's Christmas Look Week of Webisodes. Now today, Teresa is going to take us through Winter's Garden. Doesn't that just sound nice?
It does. With our new Winter's Garden collection.
Right.
Plus we also have new stamps, cutting dies, a new stencil, and all in a real wintry look.
Yeah, lots of fun goodies. Come play with us. And here is the Winter's Garden collection. Well, actually, these three are. This is Extra Dazzles. We'll talk about those in a second.
But it goes with it nicely.
It does. In fact, it goes with lots of things nicely. Let's start with the papers,
yes. Because
that's always our starting point. Winter's Garden, because it's from hot off the press, that means you're going to get ideas on the package for scrapbooking as well as card making.
Right, and on the back too, right? More ideas on the back as usual.
Right, and let's see the papers. Now these are double-sided. They are paper, they are not cardstock, and paper means that they're just more flexible, you can do more things.
Right.
And Winter's Garden has a really pretty palette. It is the light blue, you can see the reds and the greens,
right. Kind
of painted elements going
right. On.
So
it's a real wintry look, which
it
means
is.
You could use it, you know, past Christmas, beyond Christmas still for winter items.
Good
maybe
point.
New Year's, sure.
You can see that great big snowflake in the center
That's beautiful. Another.
And this is an all-over pattern, as you can see. We'll get a little bit closer. And it also picks up, but it does have more of the brown in the background,
yeah,
as you can
see. It has the browns,
see.
But those great flowers all over it.
And a fun punch
look.
Of lime green. Now here is a blue all-over snowflake. And a stripe that picks up so many of those elements and design pieces that are in the set. And then a blue tone-on-tone.
Red.
Excuse
bright
me.
Red.
I said blue, didn't I?
Yes,
what was
you
I
did.
Thinking? Okay, red. Correction. Blue is the last one.
There
got that
is.
Right? Okay, now we're going to go onto the back side, which tends to be a more generic pattern, but is so useful for combining with
right. The
others.
And as always, there are two of each of these. There are 12 total.
Exactly. And this is a stripe. You can see this very pretty, very tiny holly,
mm-hmm. Very
sweet. There is a brown all over, but again, there's design underneath it.
Always depth in our papers.
Right, and then a red to go beautifully, and that lime green with a micro dot, really, really tiny. And then here is the micro dot tone on tone in the red again.
In
so
red,
lots
not
of
blue red.
Yeah, right, this is red this time. Yeah, a little bit of a change.
We have gorgeous ribbons that go with this collection. There are 12, 36 inches each. And look at this nice wide grosgrain. I love that red. That's just gorgeous.
It is.
And there is a red dot, an edge dot, which
very
is
fun.
There's another grosgrain in a half inch with an ivory look. We've got a brown glimmer ribbon. We have like a teal swirl. I love the teal that's picked up in this paper set. And we have an eighth inch, there's that bright green in a grosgrain, fun little light green rickrack.
What mini rickrack, yeah.
A mini rickrack, a quarter inch sheer. This is kind of a real pale blue. I love having baker's twine. It's so much fun in so many different situations, and that's kind of a blue and white combination. We have another eighth inch grosgrain in a brown, and this beautiful, beautiful glitter, the red on the glitter on velvet, the glitter that doesn't come off, beautiful ribbon, and a great sheer with green dot. And I think I got everything.
I didn't count, I wasn't counting, but I'm sure you were close. Now we do have foil paper toll, and of course this is so wonderful because of the foil, and they are die cut. Teresa has some beautiful ways to use these, so that's in the package. You'll see them outside of the
right. Package
shortly.
There are always three elements on those
yeah. Foil.
It looks like more than that, but you can stack them up to get three, or you can use them individually.
Exactly. And then we have 54 die cuts, and you can see the same artwork going through with those flowers, but now we have some snowmen as right. Well as tags and frames.
So there are two sheets of this
right. Same
sheet of
two
die
identical
cuts,
sheets.
Two identical sheets, and these are great. The tags are great, and the labels for printing on, for computer journaling, great for scrapbooking, card making, or whatever.
And there is an idea on the package there. Mm-hmm. Now, the White Christmas Dazzles is a large set. two different 8 by 9 inch square or mm-hmm. rectangles.
Right.
And we can go down here and maybe see the artwork a little bit better.
That beautiful pearl finish. Is it
right.
a gold pearl or silver? It's a silver
pearl. It's a silver pearl.
But it's got gold edging, so it sort of it mixes up a little bit, that gold and silver.
There you go.
Just beautiful. Just covered with snowflakes and people sledding. I just love this set.
And there are 540 blue jewel dazzles as well as 101 of the other dazzles. So just a wonderful collection. So useful. And Teresa's done some very fun things.
Yes.
And we'll show you the other items as we come to the project.
Right.
So let's get started. Now this time we're starting with scrapbooking. Yay!
Just because it typifies that the collection, the Winter's Garden collection, so well.
Right.
We've got that border page, which is just beautifully framing these photos of a winter's day.
And you can see using those white Christmas dazzles, these giant snowflakes back here, little edges going onto
right.
the photos now, down at the bottom.
Teresa confessed that she just couldn't help tying in the pink that was in the picture, so she used the blue dazzles that comes with the scrapbooking set, but she also added the pink jewel dazzles.
Well, that can't be wrong,
no,
can
there's
it?
There's nothing wrong with that.
And look what she's done in the flowers. She stacked those dazzles
right.
and added snowflakes into the center.
She also brushed over just the large poinsettias with a clear wink of Stella brush to just give it a little extra shimmer.
Very
nice. So she
nice.
Says she's not into glitter. I kind of don't believe her anymore.
Yeah, I kind of don't either. And you can see how she's added to the art by adding those snowflakes. I just
right.
I think it's a really pretty cute, the little sledder
it is,
going down.
Sled. And then here's one of the die cuts. This is one of the little long tab die cuts. There's that one and down here. I think she cut one in half
there
to
you
get
go.
That long label.
And we have a snow angel going on. So, and we've got the sledder down there. So it really oh, does a nice job of adding to the baker's
right.
twine going along.
Mm-hmm.
So just a really gorgeous, very fun, sparkly look.
So this is it's a great page. I love the double border treatment on the opposite corners of this
mm-hmm.
large page. And you sort of see it down there and up here at the top
right.
too. It's just beautiful for framing photos.
Now, Teresa has done something different with the trees that are on that set of dazzles, and right now they're not as pearly. She's added color.
She's added multiple colors on. I just kind of like to show you how that's done without
yeah.
talking it. I just want to go right into it
okay.
and show you.
So shut up and move on, huh?
No, no, no. I would never say that. Okay, so here are those beautiful dazzles. I've got a craft sheet, I've got a palette that I'm going to place some of these Spectre Noir refill inks on. I've got a dark blue, and she calls out in the gallery, it'll be called out which ones that she used.
The letters and so forth.
Right.
Yeah.
It tells you which, based on the letters, tells you which colors they are. So we've got a dark green, a pretty dark blue as well. And then we've got a couple of cosmetic sponges here. And I'm going to start by placing that tree dazzle right onto my craft sheet. Whoops. Not the stamp.
Stay stamp.
It's really cute. I like the stamp, but I'm going for the tree.
It's not your turn.
Pull up that tree.
And this material is very substantial. It really,
oh, yeah.
you can see how laborious it was to lift that off.
Just it seems to be a little bit thicker than the just the multicolored dazzles and not the pearlized dazzles. It's just a little stiffer, so kind of easy to work with. So I'm going to start with the blue. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of that, maybe make sure that it's sort of saturated in there, and start coloring around the edges.
Ah.
So I add a little blue to one side. And it's really
okay.
pretty simple. So that's
yeah.
that's alcohol ink because that's a Spectre Noir pen refill.
Right.
And then I pick up the green. And the green, even though it's a dark green, I've noticed it sort of makes it a little lighter. It's not quite as substantial as the blue is. And that picked it up pretty good.
Yeah.
And they sort of meld in the middle. And so there you go. And
boy.
You can play with that mixture a little bit, get them together, and get a little bit of teal in the center.
How gorgeous.
It is. It's just a beautiful look.
Wow.
Okay.
And so easy to do.
Easy. Super easy to do. Let that dry, which only takes a few seconds.
Right. And then she went back in and added the jewel dazzles as well as the other snowflake dazzles from the same set.
Right.
And did some inking on the snowflakes themselves. And also on the message. So snowflakes are winter's butterflies.
Beautiful.
Very, very pretty. And again, on the winter's garden.
Right. And I can see a little strip. So cutting off the edge.
Back in, John. Back in.
Cutting off the edge of the scrapbooking dazzles, you can get a nice border for the edge of your paper there.
Very pretty.
I've seen her in the last few days. I've seen her do this particular thing a couple of times, cutting those stripes not along the way the stripes go, but opposing, you know, the opposite way that they go, and use that sort of as a border treatment on the left side of a card. That's a nice look.
And on the inside, you can see the other tree done just as beautifully.
It looks like there's ornaments on there with those little round pieces.
With those snowflakes on it. Just gorgeous. And down here, the border was also inked and colored and added with dazzles.
Okay.
Just really pretty.
So these are tiny little snowflakes set on top of the blue jewel dazzles. That's how she got that. I wasn't registering.
Got you.
Those must be on the scrapbooking dazzles.
Right.
Yeah.
They're all over.
So there's tiny little snowflakes on there.
So putting them on top of the jewel dazzles. Well, that's good to know.
It made it look like an ornament. That's
very good. Very neat. Very, very pretty.
Okay.
Now we're going to go into the paper toll. And here it is outside the package. And quite beautiful.
It is beautiful. There's I love that blue. Oh, that glitter.
That glitter.
And I love the blue in the background. It's really kind of a nostalgic look a little bit, especially with the lace of that doily.
And
a real soft look.
While we're in close, I'm going to bring in the silver flower dazzles that Teresa did, I think, yesterday.
Right.
That she added. And she was playing with them as snowflakes. Well, today they get to be flowers.
They get to be the center of those poinsettias, which is an excellent added addition. And plus the red jewel dazzles are used there and then down on the ornaments as
well. Now that paper doily is an oval. It is this giant oval, but how beautiful it is when placed into the project.
Right, so used one end of it on the front and then the other end on the inside.
Exactly.
Just beautiful.
Now, on the front, this is the foil paper toll, and it's been layered with foam tape, as I think you can see.
Right.
And the foam tape that we use is very thin, because as you're getting those layers, you don't want them to reach a half inch tall.
It's about a 16th of an inch thick, of just about that.
Now, on the inside, she used similar designs of the die cuts, so that way they coordinate. She did do one layer up, as you can see, but she really liked the idea that they were coordinating.
Right. Now the stamping that you're seeing is from the new stamp set that we have. So it's got some nice little greetings. This one says, "May your home be filled with all the love of the season."
Right. Very nice.
And it has a small stamp on the front, and that comes from
this
Home
is
for the Holidays.
Home for the Holidays. So we have all of the houses and all kinds of little other elements to use with it. Right.
Right. Lots of little things you can add around those houses that I love. The tree on the car. There's a Christmas tree decorated.
Mm-hmm.
There's a snowman, more trees, more houses.
You miss Santa. Wait.
Did
you miss Santa? Right there.
There he is. Sometimes he's hard to catch. But lots of nice little elements as far as sentiments is where there's no place like home for the holidays.
Okay.
And you're going to see those
A little bit later.
Sentiments throughout the cards. Like they've been used before we see the whole stamp set.
Right. So. Oh, right. And that Merry Christmas is part of that stamp set. Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Next,
going in here. Now, this is more of the foil paper toll.
Ooh,
you can see down here.
Look
at that.
This
is really a large cutting die. And here's what it looks like. It's called Lacy Tapestry.
4 7/8 That's almost 5 inches by 3 7/8 So almost 5 by 4
Right. So it's a really large piece. And isn't it glorious when cut out of the pearl paper? Now, we saw the silver pearl, I think yesterday, used with the ice skates.
Right.
Here is the gold pearl, but it comes in a collection of gold and silver.
These are self-adhesive. For a minute, I thought they weren't, but I double-checked yesterday. They are self-adhesive, so they're super easy to use. So you can die cut that, then pull off the back and stick it on there. And I don't think we're seeing the shimmer. We've got to...
It's
see
just
the shimmer
beautiful.
And shine of that pearl. It is
and it
gorgeous.
Has a texture to it also, that just beautiful.
That's what that pearlized part that we're talking about.
And so you can see that it makes a beautiful backdrop. And as we go out a little bit, this is a horizontal element, this being a vertical element. And it's a nice play on those two. And on the inside, Teresa has turned that sideways and added more.
She added one of the tags. These are from one of our tags, probably the 10 tags.
Probably 10
tags and trims.
Yes,
cutting
right there.
Dies. She's done stamping on there with that great stamp set that we just saw.
And this is the back side of this paper, so she simply folded it over to create a border.
I'm also seeing some of the metallic gold paper on an edge there. So a little bit of an accent there. And then a strip, just a tiny little thin strip of the gold pearl paper.
And Teresa always does such a beautiful job on her ribbons, and I think it's her floral background. But just how simple that is, not bothering with a bow, just knotting it and letting those tails just go upward.
Just beautiful.
Yeah, so just quite stunning. And what I like about this is that you can get a beautiful, beautiful look so easily.
Right.
By using
simple, a cutting die and die cuts and paper tail, and there you go.
Well, the right ones, of course, you know. Now we do have another card, and this one is featuring the 9 tiny Christmas things and shadows.
Right, so, and they're definitely focused individually by showing each one of those in a little frame of its own. We're using some of the same elements we saw on that last card. We have the gold metallic paper. We have the gold pearl sheets.
Well, the pearl sheets and then the gold metallic paper are a nice combination. You can see the gold metallic paper is the shadow and the pearl.
So each one of these are two separate cutting dies, one for the center and one for that outer shadow.
Right. You can use them together or not. Whatever you choose.
Use them individually.
And there's 2, 4, 6 of them. So let's see, the reindeer and the star haven't been
which
used.
Ones haven't
yeah,
been used.
We're not going to play that game. On the inside, Teresa has done the star.
Okay.
Yes, same way, adding that stamp again from the Home for the Holidays.
And I love the layering of all the different sorts of papers. And you're seeing the blue, you're seeing the, which I wouldn't necessarily put the blue with that green and red, but it just looks really cute together.
Works nicely. And you can see there's even some kind of embossing on that cutting die as she
trimmed it out. And that's been stamped
with
Timber Brown Stazon. Stazon is a great one for stamping on the metallic papers because they're a little bit glossy.
And this is the metallic gold. It's a 12 by 12 sheet. Again, it's a paper like the silver we talked about the other day. It is not real shiny, therefore it's a nice play against the pearl and many other things, I might add.
Lots of things.
Now we talked about that stamp, the Home for the Holidays.
There
and
we go. This is full use of it.
It is.
And go ahead. And Teresa stamped and embossed them on different colors of paper and then cut them out to get this layered look.
And what she said she wanted is she wanted the idea of different things going on, but she didn't want to spend a ton of time on it.
Okay.
So stamping it on the Winter's Garden pattern papers and doing the heat embossing with black just made it a really easy way to get this look.
And then she did layer them, but she didn't use foam tape. A lot of times in these situations, we think, well, one in front of the other, let's layer it. But this is all flat. It's a very flat card, and it looks great. It still looks very 3D. She also accented a lot of things you see here with the clear Wink of Stella.
Okay.
So the windows have been glitterized a little bit with that Wink of Stella, and definitely the snowman. And then just some extra stamping in the background as well.
And look what she did with, okay, so here's the trees.
Right.
And she has stamped behind the houses just really, really nice.
And not embossed. She embossed the houses, but she just stamped those so that they aren't quite as shiny, not quite as prominent. They're in the background.
And nonetheless, they're there. And I do love seeing the trees and
the snow, little snow drifts.
Yeah,
around.
Even the snow drifts. Those are stamps in here. So you don't have to do pen work. It's all right there, and just a little bit of touch of color.
That's an adorable card.
It is.
And certifies as adorable.
And then here is another collection on the inside. It too would make a beautiful card front.
Just
no
beautiful.
Place like home for the holidays. Just gorgeous. So
that's a great use of that stamp set.
It is.
Wonderful.
It is. Now, we have another new element in our collection. This is a dahlia, and it is very large and
right?
very striking.
But why are we doing a dahlia on Christmas?
Because it has so many other elements.
Uh-huh.
It can be transformed into a poinsettia. Did
Absolutely.
You notice?
Absolutely.
No sleight of hand was
now,
used.
If you have the dahlia, you can also use these great little butterflies
right.
that go with it, but use it this way, and it totally fits the winter's garden papers, and that is drop-dead gorgeous.
It is drop-dead gorgeous, and you see that she used the die cuts with it to kind of get the Christmas theme
right.
in there. Now, this is using the glitter gel, right?
The glitter gel on top of distress inks.
Okay.
So she started, here, I'm going to show you, I've already really gotten into this so that you can see how it's done. The stencil is sitting on top of a tan cardstock, and then I just placed it on top of another piece of cardstock just so I wouldn't get everything messy. It's taped in place, and then with two separate mini distress ink sets, I'm sure you're so used to hearing about those mini distress ink sets, and check the gallery for which ones, because she wanted to mix these particular colors. She's got Rusty Hinge on the center, and then she used Victorian Velvet, that's kind of a pink, for around the smaller petals, and then Fired Brick, which is like one of her favorite reds now.
Yes, that's her new favorite.
For the outer edges, and using the art daubers, and you get, I think, like six
mm-hmm.
of these in a set. You just pick up the ink and go right through. So I pounced through most of it, but I just wanted to show you how easy it is just to go ahead and pounce through and then sort of go around to sort of blend them with the other colors.
And Teresa commented on how easy those were to use, and
oh, yeah.
it just worked very, very nicely.
It's sort of a natural thing to just have that
yeah.
on the end of your finger and just move it around. So very simply, that's how it was done. The center, used set different ones for the different colors. And
it's a pretty combination of colors. I don't know that I would have I've chosen those,
mm-hmm.
and yet it's a gorgeous look.
But it's already pretty just like that.
Yep.
So you can leave it like that, or you can...
Well, wait. As a matter of fact, as you say that, the inside of her card is just that.
Right.
This is the stencil part doing exactly what you just did.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the front of her card...
She adds the glass bead glitter gel, which there it is.
There it goes.
it's a pretty good size. It's a 3.3 fluid ounces. There's a lot of it in there. Now, when you first look at it, it looks white, but it's got these little glass beads in there. And we've got a new what do we call these?
Palette.
Thank you. A new palette set, a couple of different ones. Choose which one works best for you. There's larger, there's smaller. And they're great for just swiping across the top of that stencil, and you're going to cover the entire piece. So I'm just going to go across it just like
And you're going to hear it kind of crunch.
Right.
Let's see.
Yeah, you can hear it sort of popping as it's moving those little glass beads around. There we go. And I'm just going to make sure that I cover it entirely. I'm going to leave it kind of thick because I want to make sure that it doesn't leave any gaps. But that's pretty much what you do. You just move it around, get it all the way across it. And when you're done,
and
I'm not going to do the entire piece right
yeah,
now.
Yeah. If you were to, go ahead and take another swipe. If you were to even remove more of the glitter, go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's going to look like it's not covered. But it will be, because when it dries, that's when you're going to see the glass beads.
Right,
so
right.
you don't need to leave a thickness of kind of like frosting.
Right. You don't want to make it too thick. I'm going to stop right
yeah.
there because I do want to show,
just
I want to
lift
show
it.
Lifting it up so that you can see that it goes around the edges.
Now it's going to be white. I guess we should have said that
right.
earlier.
So it's going to be white. It's going to look like that, but it did get, within all of the stencil.
Right.
And then
it's going to dry clear, and that's what you're going to get.
Right.
So you're getting that sparkly look, but it's embedded into that embossing paste, basically.
Right. So it picks
the
up the color.
It
when it dries clear, you can see right through to the ink. So it
right.
does that as well.
So once again, we have an amazing look easily done.
Mm-hmm.
So you can just say, oh, it was no trouble. I was happy to do it for you. And this look, I forgot that this is an easel card. So you get
Isn't
the look of the inside with the non-glitter, with the top right there.
I also like that when you open it all the way, if you totally open it up, oh, hey, there's your little, isn't that cute?
Yes, your greeting.
Hanging down at the top, and then you can prop it up.
On the die cuts
on
also.
On the die cuts.
Yeah. So I think with the combination of the die cuts added, it really does transform that dahlia into a poinsettia.
Oh, yeah. So. It's definitely a poinsettia.
Now, if you liked that look, here is an absolutely gorgeous one.
Yeah, that's a stunner for
isn't
sure.
Isn't it? And Teresa used Perfect Pearls, and right. She said she loves the metallic set, and she used two of them in combination.
And, you know, she did, uh-huh. But it turns out this is the other one isn't really available, and so this can be done. This can be done just with this one, and so you can add a little bit of a darker one, which she did around the edge, around the center, and then use the gold on most of it.
Okay.
So,
and
I've
you're going to show.
That. I've got that. So I've got the stencil already mounted on there. I've got my really well used studio version of VersaMark.
Now, there is a perfect medium comes with this. It is the same as VersaMark, so that's what you're using.
It
but
is.
In the set, you get the paintbrushes.
You do.
And the perfect
you can
medium.
Use that perfect medium just as well. It goes on there. It's a smaller, I probably should have used it, but I have the VersaMark sitting here. So.
I just don't want it to be confusing.
Right. And
so you're tapping?
Tapping. I am pressing, really.
Okay.
Not tapping. I am pressing through because I want to make sure that I get all the way through the stencil into all of the little small areas. And you're going to go all the way over this. I'm just going to do part of it. So there, I've done the top part of it. And then you're going to remove the stencil because you don't want to put the perfect pearls on the stencil. You just want it on that area that you just VersaMarked.
Besides, you want to clean off your stencil.
That as well.
Now,
I've got
I think
cleaning
you can
to do.
Maybe you can see the VersaMark there, even though it's clear on this cream paper.
Right. So let me go ahead and put it here so we don't make too much of a mess. And I've got the gold, the perfect gold. And you just add it on. You just sort of pounce it around. I move it around, you can see that immediately.
It's just such magic.
Right, it is.
I just love
it's
it.
It's so beautiful.
And the Perfect Pearls is a combination of mica powders,
mm-hmm.
and I like the fact that they're naturally occurring.
Right. And if you want to, you can sort of go around the edges and make a little bit of a darker edge.
Is that with the copper?
This one is the bronze.
The bronze?
This is the bronze. Copper would be a little darker, but gives you a little bit of a different look there.
And that is also in the same set.
Right.
So
this is all within one set.
Bronze, copper, gold, and pearl.
And that will be reflected on the gallery as well.
Right.
We've made it so that you can see that. So
there
anyway,
you go.
Just a beautiful
gorgeous.
Look.
Gorgeous. Now here is her finished one. She did add the gold sparkle holographic, just a touch as the matte. So you can see how beautifully that connects all the golden elements.
Right. The gold sparkle, the gold metallic in the background. Here's the stamp, the same stamp set was used for this small stamp here. And I love that tiny little label, which I believe was done with the tiny tags and labels.
Tiny tags and little labels. Yep,
there
that cutting die. And on the inside,
great.
Teresa has,
another
because
one.
This is such a large stamp or large stencil, I think that's really fun to let that pop from the top.
Right.
Or it could have popped up from the bottom like that.
It
or
could.
From the
that's
side.
Great.
You know, you can
it's
do whatever
sort of
you like.
Down from
yeah.
The top. Another one of the tiny tags and little labels cut out there with a little stamp, a little bit of stamping.
And
in.
This is the gold paper we showed earlier. So nice to see that used multiple times.
So this is a rather large card. I want to measure
is.
It. So let's see. It is about 7 inches by 6 inches.
Okay.
Now that's not a standard size.
It's not. So Teresa decided to make an envelope, and she used
the envelope punch board.
There
to
you
do
go
that.
To do that. And directions are in the gallery. So this is
and directions are in the gallery. Also, there's a very good product video with the envelope punch board. It shows you just how to use it.
Great. Now Teresa said that because this is oversized, you couldn't mail it with all of this on the front. So that you would need to hand deliver. Tuck if you're giving a gift.
Hey, you could put the whole thing in another envelope, mail it that way if you felt that this recipient deserves something special like that.
There you go.
Okay.
Choices and options. The same tiny tags was used right there. So
to get that center label.
Beautiful, stunning, beautiful, gorgeous.
Beautiful winter's garden collection and extras.
And more stuff. So we hope you'll join us tomorrow for the last day of Teresa's Christmas Look Week of Webisodes.
We've got some great techniques tomorrow.
We do. See you then.
Bye-bye.